Welcome to another episode. Hey, my name is Mark Hunter, the sales hunter. Gerhard Schwantner, Selling Power, Sales Conference 3.0 is here. And more importantly, Elay Cohen. Now, hey, take a look at the book, Saleshood. That's what we're talking about here today.
Elay, thank you for joining us. What I'm most interested in is what made you decide to write the book? Why is that book necessary?
You know, I started writing the book at about early 2012. And, you know, I felt like there was a lot of good momentum, an amazing, we did so much good work in those years at Salesforce, the hypergrowth years. And I felt like it was important to document. It was important to document the best practices. It was important to document how we went from, you know, 300 million to 3 billion in run rate. It's incredible. Hypergrowth. We were hyper-focused on enablement. And as I reflected on my time and the successes at Salesforce, I realized that one of the most critical elements of success was the tight partnership between myself, between the enablement organization, and the frontline managers. And the book is taking the best of the best of enablement and ultimately teaching managers to bring it to their teams.
So what support did you get from Mark Benioff?
Enablement was top of mind for Mark, top of mind for the entire leadership team. And I remember getting a call from Mark, and that call said, well, now that you're heading up enablement, what's your plan? And, you know, that was somewhat of a loaded question because he had a vision for it. And, you know, we spent a couple hours on the phone, and he really introduced me to this idea of a mantra, a messaging mantra. And he said to me, you know, we've got an amazing product. We're really at the beginning of dominating the market. You know, cloud was really at the emerging state. And he said, we got to get every single salesperson on message, every single salesperson sharing the same stories, selling the same way. And he said, when we bring our team together at our kickoff event. So this was, you know, he called me 2 months before our kickoff event, and he said, I want a mantra. I want everybody saying the same thing. And he, you know, started, you know, even he went as far as saying, let's just a meditative mantra. I want everyone walking away understanding how we're going to win. And that was the marching orders that we got, because we took that mantra metaphor and then we repeated it quarter after quarter after quarter after quarter around the new corporate pitches, the sales playbooks. And so we always had support from Mark and expectations that we were gonna, you know, deliver excellence around enablement.
It's wonderful. And I read the book, and the mantra is success.
Each letter stands for another acronym, another value. So the first S in success is seed and grow. We ultimately believed that if we could win over a customer, win a division, win a team, win a department, that we ultimately would be able to seed the success of Salesforce into that business. The U was users sell for you. Now, I just want you to remember, this is 2006, 2007, right? There wasn't a whole, you know, customer marketing, you know, so users sell for you meant we believe that when we could get our customers to share their stories, that they would actually do the selling for us. So when we would identify a qualified customer, you know, rather than go deep in demos and what we would do, we'd say, hey, you know what? We want you to talk to one of our customers. And then the next letter, C, is compelling demos, right? We knew we win because we could customize the demos, tailor them to the customer's business, use their vernacular. And then, another one was connect the dots. And connect the dots basically meant, you know, chances are we know someone who knows someone inside of a company. So why not leverage that relationship? Relationship selling and relationship building was a key part of our strategy. And then the E is experience events and success, experience events. Think about Dreamforce. Think about all of the events. You know, we believe that if we can bring customers to an event, that they will feel the energy of what we were doing. They would connect them with other customers. And then the final two, the two S's, sell high and through and show them the money. Show them the money is quintessential value-based selling, build a business case, show value, and sell high and through is make sure you are building a political map, you understand the decision process. the lesson was, Mark said, let's build our mantra. Let's make it be who we are. Let's have it extract from our wins. Let's make it map to our culture. And then let's drive it through the organization or kickoff. And then I want this to be the foundation of our enablement go forward.
So now comes the big challenge. How do you remember all seven?
So, you know, we would reinforce it all the time. So let's go through the life cycle of enablement. You hire someone, we would hire 25 to 50 new people a month. Their first hour at boot camp, one of our sales leaders is introducing success and explaining their story. So we are immediately, you know, driving that mantra on their first day, first hour on the job. Whenever we do, we used to do weekly calls called sharing success calls. We would always reinforce the success formula inside of those calls. We would highlight a letter a week. We would highlight stories per week. At our kickoff events, when people would get up on stage, while the sales professionals and the sales teams were sharing their amazing stories, behind them would be the success formula, highlighting the specific letters. We had the printouts and the pinups. We knew we were successful because people would print it out. We had them laminated. We put them on the desks. We also updated the Salesforce system. So the page layout of Salesforce.com had the specific fields on there. We also created reports for the managers. So when they ran their weekly pipeline forecast calls, they were driving reinforcement coaching and reinforcement learning across each of the letters. So they would have their pipeline reports would also include the answers to the questions on their deals. Those are some ways, Gerhard, how we ultimately reinforced it in the organization.
What Elay just really talked about was this whole mantra. Oh, gee, that's what we always talk about in sales meetings. But the follow through. And it really became more than just, oh, these are what the words mean. It was a lifestyle. You really created in the organizational lifestyle.
You really have embedded in the sales culture a DNA formula that allowed salespeople and sales leader to counteract what is happening everywhere, which is the world is exploding. The world is a divergent world. And the mantra allows you to converge and focus on what is important now.
You know, another statement that I remember, you know, being challenged with from the leadership team at Salesforce and Mark was, I don't care where I am in the world. If I'm in Sydney, if I'm in New York, if I'm in London, if I'm in Tokyo, if I'm in Munich, if I'm in Austin, it doesn't matter where I am. It doesn't matter who I'm meeting with. When I am sitting down with a sales team and a customer, I want the same pitch. I want the same plays. I want the same execution.
If I'm in my company and I've been tasked with sales enablement, but my leadership is not embracing it, what do you think I should be doing to help get my management on board?
The best thing that we can do is look for proof points. And so I didn't start with 120 people at Salesforce on my team. You know, what I'll do personally is I'll pick a manager and I'll start focusing on one team, and I'll do more enablement with that manager and that team to demonstrate that, look what happens if we enable this one team. Look at their attainment. So ultimately, I'm looking for proof points around some kind of revenue attainment or pipeline attainment. So my recommendation to any enablement person is pick a specific metric, pick a team, build value, build the proof point. Don't feel like you got to do it for everyone at first. Just take it slow. Everybody will come, or every organization will ultimately embrace enablement. It's a movement. It's happening. It's the last mile of a go-to-market. We're at the forefront of a big, big change in how companies enable their employees. And you got to start with the stories and the proof points, Mark.
I love it. That's great. And it's really easy. I mean, anybody can embrace that. And then you take those results up the ladder. Show.
So to wrap it up, let's get your thoughts on the future of sales enablement. Where do you see the profession heading?
A lot of people would sit here and espouse artificial intelligence, AI, and machine learning, and, you know, sales bots. And, you know, I think there's a place for that amazing technology, and it's going to ultimately help us, but it's going to help us. I think we're going to move into a phase of enablement where engagement is the primary measure of success. And engagement is more, you know, team huddles, more team collaboration, more coaching, more managers doing coaching, more engagement between people sharing stories. So enablement is going to be, and this is my prediction, is going to be about, and it's going to be measured by the human-to-human engagement.
A lot more human engagement. I'm going to pick up on something. We were talking about the success formula, that first S, seed, that last S, show the value. You know, you think about it. Not only does that work for customers, but that works for sales enablement. Just as like you described, Elay, in terms of I'm a sales enablement manager. How do I do it? I seed. I create little wins. I show the value. I go up the ladder. I create a bigger home run for my company and myself through sales enablement.
I'm very impressed by the way Mark Benioff has created the challenge for you to come up with a mantra. And a mantra is something that is a focusing tool that brings out the best in people. And you being able to articulate that and convert a lot of people, and first you pull it out of the culture, and then you create that grid, and then you test it and prototype it, you roll it out, and then all of a sudden it moves sales from 300 million to 3 billion. And today Salesforce.com is the first company in the history of US business that has gone from zero to 10 billion in sales in record time. They're the number one, they're the leader.
Record time. It's amazing. The whole success formula and the strategy to build the success formula is in the book, chapter 2. And if anyone wants to learn more, you know where to find me.